facing the unknown. It's hard enough for adults to ease their high anxiety during this COVID pandemic. But what about children? What can we do to calm their fears? Take a look.
During these uncertain times, kids are dealing with more fear and anxiety than ever before. Parents are searching for ways to ease those fears. Emmy Award winner, best-selling author, and mother of three, Elizabeth Hasselbeck, wants to help. In her book, Flashlight Night, An Adventure in Trusting God, Hasselbeck encourages kids to have faith and hope in God, knowing that He hears our prayers, even when we don't see an answer.
Please welcome to the 700 Club, Elizabeth Hasselbeck. Elizabeth, it's great to have you with us today.
Thank you for having me, Terry. This is a blessing to be here and share the morning with all of you. Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about your children, because, of course, we know your husband's sports background. We know your background and the many endeavors you've had. But tell us about your children.
They are amazing. Tim and I are just really thankful to have brothers and sisters in Christ in Grace, Taylor, and Isaiah. They are all unique, and we love them uniquely. They have the big hearts. They are curious, and they have been, like many other kids, really trying to navigate 2020 remote learning, cancellations, and this world that kind of took everyone off guard. So I think just trying to steward the mindset in our homes well as parents has been the ultimate challenge for many of us, but we can do that with hope.
Absolutely. You say that your children were part of the inspiration for this book. Talk a little bit about the premise behind Flashlight Night.
Sure. Grace, Taylor, and Isaiah, and Tim quietly, he doesn't like to have cover credit, but they really were co-authors through this whole process. And it all really began when one of their friends, Caroline, took my hand and showed me how her family prayed on a wall. And I thought, wow, what a power in showing someone how open you can be with God. So that inspired our chalk wall right here. And then I think God knew that I need a little extra credit work, because He's like, Elizabeth, how can we explain to these children when you're asking them, you know, Tim and I were like, how can we ask them to pray about big things when the answer might be no? You know, mm-hmm. I didn't want them to break prayer time with God. And so that's where the Flashlight came in, with Flashlight Night. And it's a sweet little book. And when we see God working, we come up here in the dark. And just like we see the wall, when the light is off and we don't see the wall, it's still there. So what we do is we shine our light on where we see God working, like, hey, Super Mimi, happy birthday, John. And when we pray about things that don't seem answered, we're honest with God. And we shut our flashlight off and say, God, I don't see an answer yet. And I don't see what you're doing, but I'm trusting you're there working on it, because that's who you are. And so allowing kids to pray about big things and small things, and they're all big to kids. Nothing's too big for God to handle, and nothing's too small. That project you have at school, that friend that you want to ask you to maybe hang out in a distanced way, this COVID thing that you want to go away, nothing is too small or too big for God. His might and His tender love for you is there. And so I think having a way to be honest with Him was the key.
Mm-hmm. In the book, you have this, and I see it behind you. You have actually painted a whole wall with chalkboard paint. And obviously, you've used that with your children regularly. Yes. But not everybody has the capacity to do that. How do you suggest they take what you've done with your children and apply it to their situation?
Sure. Tim was awfully surprised when he came home one day and found our wall was fine. It was gray. It was fine. And it became painted black. What I did was in the book, and God really put this on my heart. And let me just say, this is all God just working through His people, right? So this is actual chalk paper inside the book. So you can go in. So every child can have a flashlight night right here in the book, and then shine light on where they see God working, and get honest and turn it off where they don't. And I think for a parent to see what's on your children's hearts, and for them to see what's on our hearts, is key. They don't have to carry worry alone and fear alone. God does not give us a spirit of fear. He gives us a spirit of power and love and a sound mind, right? So we want these things out of our kids. They want them out of us, actually. And then we get to see each other, and then we get to hope together, and then we get to be honest with God. He's a good God. He knows our hearts. And He doesn't want us carrying these worry rocks alone all day.
It's actually good for our children, I think, to recognize that we have concerns too, and that we too are trusting God every day and hoping for all of the blessings and the things that are a promise to God's children. There's so much negativity around, not just for our kids, but for adults as well. You're hearing about it on the news every day. What other ways do you and Tim encourage your children with hope and faith at a time like this?
You know, truly, Terry, during this time, if anything has felt dark and confusing and uncertain and things not being answered, it was 2020 and the beginning now of that things aren't all of a sudden better. And I think when you ask family to pray and then you're getting what feels like a no, the continuation of prayer, like we're going to constantly bring our requests to God. And we know we just practice really like it's been a lot of flashlight off, but also celebrating. I think one of the most important things is gratitude and that flashlight on moment, just like these two sweet kids have their flashlight on. Gratitude for the things that are working out that you can see. So you practice gratitude. So we write down fun things. Like during quarantine, we wrote down all the cool things we did inside our house. Sometimes you need to change your focus and understand, like, as a family, it might not look how we thought it did, but let's look for the good.
Yeah.
And let's bring the honest heart to God. Like, just like I don't want my kids hiding from me when things feel hard for them. God's a good parent. He wants us to come to him and say, like, I am struggling. I don't see what you're doing with this new curfew. I don't see what you're doing, why I can't go do what I want to do. I don't see what you're doing when our friend didn't have one more day on this planet. I don't see that, God, but I'm still trusting you because you're good. And I know you're good because I've seen you in my life before. And I know I'm going to see you work again. And we might not all see it right now, but one day we'll understand. And I think giving kids the practice of prayer through hard times is what Flashlight Night is about.
And just being family together, walking the walk together. Elizabeth's new book is called Flashlight Night. It is charming. It's filled with beautiful pictures inside. And she's even given you your own chalkboard right inside. So you don't have to paint your wall. You can just get her book. It's sold wherever books are sold. Elizabeth, thanks. It's great to have you with us.
Thank you so much, Terry. God bless you all.
Uh-huh.